Hello guys, DC Gaming here, and today I'm back with another video. So today's video is going to be a different kind of video. It is going to be a new series that I may be starting, I hopefully will, about every new map when it comes up. I hopefully will be doing these kinds of videos, but right now I'm just going to be doing them like a few at a time because I haven't done them for the past few maps. So if you guys haven't noticed by then, the very beginning in the thumbnail or the title, this is Zombies Bootcamp. So basically, I know not everyone's the best player, so I am going to be telling you my like strategies. These aren't the complex strategies, these are just the basics and like uncommon facts that seem common once you get good at zombies. So first things first, before you do anything, many people just go up and knife zombies. You don't want to do that. What you want to do is to keep a distance and do 7 shots in each leg, then or 8 shots now that because you have the MR6 has more ammo than the original pistol in Black Ops 2. And then, so as you can see here, I missed a few, but that doesn't really matter. Just get 7 shots in the leg or 8 shots in the leg and then a knife, and do this for the first 3 rounds. And even if you're out of ammo, just start knifing, and maybe occasionally buy an RK5, but what I do, I don't usually, I just survive it out. But then again, now that I'm thinking about it, if you're a beginner, I wouldn't risk this. So I'd buy an RK5, but look, I have all that points. So first things first, buy the KRM. That's a pretty safe bet. It's a shotgun, it'll keep you good. And this map is for the giant, this boot camp, so the things that I tell you in here might work for other maps, but might not be the best. So after you get this, you just want to survive a few rounds so you're ranking up a good amount of points. I'd recommend up on the catwalk, that's a pretty good place. And then once you have a good amount of points, like 1,500, you'd want to jump down and grab the CAN-44. This is a really good point racker along with an amazing gun. You can survive to around like 20 with double tap and speed cola with this unpacked punch, and with it, packed punch is just amazing. So what you want to do then is just survive a bunch of rounds with these guns until you get to a dog round, because then what you want to do, there'll be a max ammo. A lot of people know this, but I never know. Some people aren't the best, and people have been recommending this, so I'm gonna just make this video. There will be a max ammo, so when you're killing the dogs, make sure you use the gun that has the more ammo, and you want to keep your guns reloaded before you get the max ammo, because then you'll get more ammo than you could if your guns were empty. After that, once you have enough points, I'd recommend like a few thousand, start linking the teleporters. What this does, this opens up Pack-a-Punch. And some people don't know this because they never played the old Call of Duties. It will lower the Pack-a-Punch, the little, what should I call that? Like the shield. And it will actually spawn in a perk. But one thing to be aware of, that little telepad, that's also linking the teleporter so you can actually teleport. But that telepad, it will shoot up like, I don't know, like electricity, and it'll kill any zombies on that. So be careful if you have like a last zombie like I'm doing here. I believe that in this one, I actually accidentally killed my zombies. I don't know for sure, but I might. And so it's pretty handy. You can get power-ups, anything from death machines. Yeah, like right there, it killed my zombie that was up there. And here I get a death machine. But another cool thing that not a lot of people know, you can actually get perks in there. So you could essentially get all the perks on the map if you had on the house and you did that. And then after that, around round 12, that would be a good time. Just, you should have all of them linked. Like, just take your time. If this is too fast for you, don't try rushing, because that's what kills you in zombies, especially on solo. And then that will be the final one, and I recommend packing as soon as, actually no, I don't recommend packing as soon as you can. That's a mistake a lot of people make, because you can't, ammo is a lot more expensive after you pack punch, so try to use your beginning gun as long as you can before it's weak. In this gameplay, I actually just pack a punch because I don't know why. I played a giant a lot, so I don't have to use that strategy. But that's what I'd recommend. Like when I play on new maps, I try to see as long as I can without pack punching, because I don't want to waste my pack punched ammo. Then after that, you just want to survive for the next rounds with your unpack punched weapon until it starts becoming bad. And then once you notice it's bad, come back here, pack a punch that weapon, and that. When that weapon's good again, go back to the first weapon you pack punch. Also, pack punch your weaker weapon first. Don't pack punch your better weapon, because you want to, like, the better weapon can survive on its own and the weaker weapon can't, so you want to pack punch that. Finally, this is another camping spot that you can camp at, and basically, I just got bored of catwalk, so I came down here. Sadly, this is where I die, but basically, it was just because I'm fooling around. I wasn't actually going for a high round attempt. My actual highest is 46 on the giant, so I'm not usually as bad as I am in this gameplay. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this. If you guys like these kind of videos, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.